Hey guys, so DeepSeek R1 came out, and it's awesome, cheap, and open source. I personally didn't have my bingo on the CCP being the champion of open source, but hey, that is our timeline. And so we can see that DeepSeek R1, right, it is in the same tier as OpenAI 01. And don't you worry, we're gonna circle back to it. And on this chart, we really can't see much else. It's on one level. Yeah, you can download it yourself, but you probably don't have the hardware. I don't have the hardware. But I do wonder if the smaller models eventually gonna be available for cheaper. Yeah, let's look at another benchmark. This is the Aether polyglot leaderboard. And O1 is leading, right. Only beaten by R1, followed by Sonnet, followed by DeepSeek V3. The main selling points of these LLMs would be that, well, first of all, they are open source, but also they are pretty dang cheap. So DeepSeek V3 would be cheaper than basically everything else, well, at least in the same performance tier. There's nothing above it. Well, you can argue that Claude Sonnet, well, could be on the same tier, but it's much more expensive. And most things that are even experimental are kind of pointless. But DeepSeek is even better than that. DeepSeek R1. Because of the thinking functionality that I would argue you would normally don't use. Unless you really need a well thought out answer. On the live bench leaderboard, it is a very similar situation. We got DeepSeek only behind, in this case, O1. But may not be in every category. Like we can see that it's mostly equivalent, but it's kind of falling behind in language, but also kind of pulling ahead in data analysis. But most importantly, DeepSeek R1, at least the chat version of it, is free to use. And even the API is reasonably affordable, at least compared to their competition. The only con, if you can call it that, of these thinking models is that it takes longer to get an answer because it actually has a thinking process, I suppose. And the price of DeepSeek chat is currently pretty dang low. But I guess even later, even if we don't hit the cash, which is probably going to be the likely outcome, it's going to be 27 cents and $1.1 out. And the DeepSeek reasoner model is only twice as expensive, right? Which might seem a lot without actually looking at the competition. Because we have Claude here. Claude 3.5 Sonnet. That's $3 in and 15 out, right? So assuming, for sake of argument, that we're going to be paying for 1 million in and 1 million out. But realistically speaking, for a normal use case, you're going to be paying more for out. Because you might be prompting with one sentence, and you're getting possibly multiple pages worth of answers. Regardless, Claude is about 7 times more expensive than DeepSeek, and Claude doesn't even think the true competition that's truly in its performance tier would be O1. That is $15 in and $60 out, right? So DeepSeek R1's out token cost is $2.2. While OpenAI's, well, arguably closed AI's O1 is 60. But regardless, the best part is that you can just use this constantly. So, if you go on the DeepSeek website, you can actually turn on search, and you can also turn on DeepSeek, DeepThink. So, previously, you can only have one, but currently, you can have both. So I asked it which DeepSeek they are, and they told me that they are the R1 live preview. So maybe it's gonna get even better than this. I can ask it some serious questions, but I cannot possibly outdo the Big Shot benchmarks. So tell me which League of Legends character is the very best. Okay, the user is asking which League of Legends character is the very best. First, I need to remember the best can be subjective in a game like League of Legends. Now, very interesting is that if you read through its thinking process, you might learn something. Not only learning how it got to the certain conclusion, but kind of like how to approach problems. Because I would argue it has a pretty good approach. The user might be new to the game. Oh my god. I never played League of Legends. I just know of it. I should mention different roles, like ADC, mid jungle. Okay, okay. I played some Dota very much in the past. Okay? So, it's highly subjective. That's unacceptable. Anyway, I forced it to give me an answer. Just say one name. And apparently the answer is Irelia. Okay, let's go round two. Tell me a relative value of resources in a game beyond all reason. This is their website. Oh, I actually posted their website. Didn't I? If not, then even more impressive. So, this is a not as well-known game. And actually has information about it, no doubt, from the internet. And thought about... So essentially, this is akin to Total Annihilation, the OG game. So because I wasn't that subjective, okay, I consider build power energy and says what resource, at what stage of the game, how important, and various synergies, all right? Give me a spreadsheet about the relative value of resources, right? And the answer is not even the interesting part here, but that it talked for 20 seconds considering various variables, I suppose, that it should consider. Look at this. That's all it did. That is very different from just pulling something on off the internet and just getting an answer out as soon as you can. And apparently this is the answer. I particularly like that. Apparently you would have like, usually you would have a 1 to 5, but yeah, I said, fuck that. 6 stars to metal in the mid game. You might consider this a mistake, but I kind of like it because it went to 1 to 5 high, but like said, like, oh yeah, we need one more for critical. And give me a strategy to win 1v1. So apparently I should prioritize metal, then energy, then build power. All right. Transitioning the T to end timing push and aiming for 4,000 metal to build advanced mechs. All right. It's even suggesting me that I should keep my AKs at range against the PVs. All right. But the interesting part there is that how long it thinks and how much it thinks to actually give you an answer. But the best part, that it's not like behind the paywall. You can just use it yourself as much as you want.